Hey everyone, I'm here with my thoughts about the LEGO Icons Lamborghini Countach 5000 Quattro Valvole. It's coming out July 1st. Sorry, I didn't get the news video about this out yesterday when it was first announced, but I was finishing the Baradur set over on Twitch so that I can start working on the review for that. Again, this comes out on July 1st, $180 US, it's 180 euros, 160 pounds UK, or $240 Canadian for 1,506 pieces. This is in a similar scale, like a 1/11th scale, approximately similar scale to the other big, formerly Creator Expert, now Icons cars that they've been doing. And first impression is good with one small exception. It does look like these here on the front are prints after all. Looks like that's also probably a print. The shaping of the fenders here is fantastic. Absolutely no gap whatsoever in there. This shaping is exquisite. It might be a little bit too much of a gap here, like too much of a step there, but that's really nitpicking. There's something else that I specifically don't like about this, but I'll get to that. I'm gonna focus on just kind of the overview first. Notice the doubled up rear tires, which is the right idea. It's a lot better than just doing singles in the back. You need those thick tires at the back, so I'm glad that they included that in there. I just have to say this up front. Yes, I'm fully aware of the rebrickable thing based on the Porsche, just because a lot of people are going to want to comment about that. But this is its own thing, and obviously an official product licensed through LEGO with Lamborghini. It looks like that is actually a sticker. So print sticker, I'm assuming. Wow. Oh, is this a new piece? Or it's a fairly new piece. I don't they just release so many new pieces so frequently, it's hard to keep up with them unless you buy absolutely every single set out there. Oh, so it's narrow tire and wide tire side by side in the back, so it's not just doubled up. So much of the shaping back here, just like with the Speed Champions version, I like. The front tires might be too narrow though, at least, I don't know, this is just kind of cut weird there. The photoshopping is weird. The trunk opens up, the deck lid opens up. Nice work with the intakes there. I'm assuming these are whip pieces used around here in the red color there. Yeah, you got some studs on top. It's Lego, you know. I think that's okay. The nice thick hips as well. I think this right in here could have been either smoothed in just at the front, could have been smoothed down a little bit, or they could have extended just a little bit around the split around the sides just to make that flow together a little bit better. Oh, this is nice. This is a really nice shot showing all of them. Well, not all of them, but a bunch of them together. Most recent ones. I guess these are ones that are still available, or is the Porsche already discontinued? Wait. Oh, there's a spinner. Let me see if there's anything else as well. Yes, this is really good. This is what you want to see. It's too bad it's a render. Now I'm going to tell you the thing that I don't like about it. It's the exact same. I have this exact same problem with this that I had with the DeLorean that they did. It's the windows are just too small. The frame around the side window is too thick. So, oh, okay. So they went with gray. So you've got a light gray here to start the transition. I think that should have been black. The next line in, probably the A-frame is fine, but the roof line is way too deep, way too thick right there. And this side window ends up just looking like it's squinting compared to even the blacked out area back here by the side intakes, you know? Yeah, that really detracts from me. Otherwise, I think most of this is good. And I'm going to show you exactly what I mean by that. Let me just make sure they don't have any other videos. No, that's it. So if we come back to here, check this out. If we come back to here, right? Look at this picture. So you can see that. Now look at the real thing. Big eye, right? Big side window. I'm not worried about the individual lines in there. It's Lego. I think that overall good job is done, but big eye on the side. This presents larger than the blacked out area just behind it. It's like this. It's not like this, you know? And also again, just that little bit of front bit right in here, I thought could have been smoothed in just a bit more. So again, coming back to here, thinking that if this was just widened out by the width of a plate, if that was possible, or something to bring this in, that's a real nitpick. But the eyes, the windows are definitely much farther off, and it's, I think, the least accurate thing about this. Otherwise, I'm super happy to get this. I'm surprised that they made it in white. I wish they'd made it in another color. I'm sure that that is a decision that's more made by Lamborghini itself. They, you know, not too long ago, with at the same time as the Speed Champions version was released, they also had the Aventador-based modern Countach, which I think is kind of a shame. It's an amazing performing car, but doesn't look enough like the Countach, doesn't have enough of the retro in it. But, you know, that one was white. They're doing this one white as well. I'm assuming that there's intended to be a connection there. But it would be nice to get this in like a yellow, I think. You got to leave red for the Ferraris. I get that. The F40, they need to do a 512 Testarossa, etc. But this one, I think, should not have been white because we've already got a Porsche. Look, it's right there. it's right there. That's too bad. But I don't think that Lego had too much skin in that game. I don't think that they could control that that much. But overall, I think this looks good. Of course, I will buy this. I will definitely build it live over on Twitch, and I'll do a full review of this, of course, on YouTube, my Lego Reviews channel, and I'll bring it over to the TikTok side as well, in just the regular landscape format. But yeah, it's not too far away. It's just the beginning of next month, so I look forward to that. Thank you for watching. Again, sorry for being slow on this, but talk to you soon.